Yeah.
So which part of Iowa are we in right now, Damien?
Eastern. Right off the Mississippi. I don't know if you saw it when you came in your way.
Is that what that little stream was?
Yeah.
So doe, fawn, spike, button buck.
Mature deer.
Mature deer.
Oh, okay. We're in Iowa. Come on.
Does and bucks.
Yeah, but we got 3 days and this we don't want to ruin it on the first day.
Oh, I know. I'm talking to myself. We're in Iowa. I can't expect a spike.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, this property
probably be hard pressed to find someone who's
this is about as good as it gets for a piece of property for something that's
in town.
In town, private.
Where do you usually kill them?
There's a ridge right there. They come up this funnel right here. There's a great big oak back there. It's a double stand in it. Many, many deer have been killed there. That's where all those ones were. But they all came through here. That's where Lucky died. And many others.
So we're just trying to find the perfect set for all three of us.
Because they're going to come from this bottom. There's a draw right there. They always come up that. And they either go straight or filter out.
This is the thickest part.
Okay.
They're going to come through here. So we need to... There is three trees here. One there. There's a smaller one there. And there's another one a little bit farther down the line for a southwest wind. That should be perfect. Right here, Damien?
Yeah.
And there's one right there. And then there's one right down there. I thought it was stuck in the ground. That sucks.
I think you about cut his head off. Filthy animals.
Huh?
Filthy animals.
I can hardly see through my peep. I forgot to turn it.
Did you see that doe that came in from behind us?
Huh.
Early?
Oh, I saw you point something out. I never saw it.
Oh, yeah. She came in and was coming around that way. She's coming in pretty good. I don't think she even cared to smell this. I think she just kind of got us all in a row. Like, because I could have shot her, but she was like just a little bit too many limbs in the way.
Right.
But, yeah, she was a big one, too.
No, I didn't see her.
What?
Is it right after this guy come through?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Pretty much right after.
Kind of like setting a buck fire here. Putting the lighter fluid on.
How far are we going to drag this?
All the way to the stand.
How far is that?
About 3/4 of a mile probably.
You're going to pull them all in.
That's what we're hoping. We're going to use every last drop. I didn't buy it to save it. This is the last day with Huntography, so let's see if we can do this. All right, this is the City of Davenport property that we can hunt. It's public, so it's CRP here, and railroad tracks there. We can't hunt the railroad tracks, but we hunt about 50 feet to the south. We've got a wooded area all the way out here to the south. It's got a nice deep creek going all the way through it. It opens up into big heavy oaks down here at the end, which is all still public. So we hear there's a bunch of big bucks back here. The guys that you have to shoot 3 does last year to be able to get a buck tag to shoot a buck back here. So all the guys that are hunting here right now don't have buck tags, and we actually both have buck tags. So we're gonna see if the story's true, if these big bucks are back here, and we don't care how big they are today, we're gonna get what we can get. Last day cliche here in Iowa. This is the freshest sign we got right here.
Yeah.
And those hoof prints are nice.
There's some rubs and along the field. A good trail. I don't know how fresh the trail is, but it's been used.
And that's brand new.
There's no fresher scrape than that. You saw how many leaves fell today, and there's nothing on that. And his tracks lead out there.
There's no reason that you guys can't sit right by each other. If Rudy goes up that wall and you go up that one right there.
That's leaning way back like this.
This one is?
Yes.
Dang it.
Still, settle down. Give some time for everything to expire.
whip out some tags in a little bit. Bag them, tag them, and drag them, baby. Whew. That's how we roll.
Man, it is record cold today for November 13th.
As Opie in Michigan says, it's a tit bit nipply outside.
Yeah, buddy. For November 13th, it's 20 degrees. This is record temperature today. We're headed into some state ground. Try something a little bit different here today. It's a good spot. I've been in there a bunch of times, seen a pile of deer. For state ground in Iowa here, it doesn't get hunted that often, so we should be pretty good this morning. We'll try to get the window clear off here.
Seeing a deer would be great.
Yeah. With the way the weather's been, I don't think it's going to be any problem seeing deer. Right there it is, boys. That's what we're looking for. That's what we're after right there. Awesome.
Seen half a dozen deer by now. I don't know if lockdown has anything to do with it, but you'd think the does that aren't being with bucks would at least be on the move, and we're not seeing nothing. Wind's perfect, 15 miles per hour, it's 20 degrees, it's just prime rut condition.
I think I'm a jinx.
I gotta agree with Rudy, he's a jinx. We got a lot of time yet.
Meh.
I was just telling Rudy earlier, we should have seen a bunch of deer by now, but that's one thing that's magical about the rut. You just never know. They just appear from out of nowhere. I clanged the antlers together real quick for a little bit, looked up the ravine, and sure enough, here he came. You might see 17 deer one day, one deer another day, but you only need to see just that one deer. And right there, that was that one deer.
That was one tall deer.
Yeah. Well, what I needed to do was I needed to clear this right here. So you can see I aimed 8 to 10 inches too low and hit this tree. If I would have made it over top of here, I'd have been in there. So I think the deer was a little bit further than what I thought it was. I range found it later and it was 42 yards and I had my 30 yard pin and held just a tad high. So I should have held a lot higher than what I did. But it's in there. I've just got a camera set up over a scrape right here. It's been about a week since I've been in here. Not even sure if we have that buck that I missed on camera, but I'll check it here to see. It's one thing about these cameras, you can check them right on field. There we go.
Yeah, I got it.
There's, see what this guy looks like here. It's definitely not the one I shot at, but that's a nice body deer there. I don't know about the rack. Let's see what else we got here. Whoops. There's a deer there. Two deer. Two doe. See, they're in here. Just weren't in here when we're in here. Wow, look at that buck. That's a shooter.
Let me see that.
That's a shooter right there, mister.
I can't see.
Look at that, Rudy.
Oh man, he is nice.
That's a nice buck. Almost makes me glad I missed that one today. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Nice buck. That's easily 170 inch deer, 5.5 year old deer. That's incredible. Like I said, makes you almost glad that I missed. Shoot a buck today. That was a 150, 160 inch deer. 32 yards. I put my 30 yard pin right on him. I don't think I didn't shoot for hard. I just shot dead center. That's where I messed up. You can see it. called killing, it's called hunting. We got a lot of time yet. There's a bunch of bucks in here. There's trail camera pick of 180 plus that we had too, so be discouraged a little bit, but never give up, and we're gonna get back at it. We'll get her done. They keep getting bigger, that's for sure. The only one left is that big 180 plus. He'll probably be in right
at dark. The misses keep getting bigger too.
Yeah. Last one I missed low, this one missed high, and next one's gonna die.
I hope so. I'm running out of batteries. All this great footage is burning up my camera.
Public ground, South Central Iowa.
That's crazy. Most people would love to even get a glance at one of those guys on public land. You got two in one day.
Yeah. This is a good spot.
That's what happens when you do your homework.
Yeah. This is a perfect funnel. I just knew it was good as soon as I seen it.
Yeah, you heard that. You know what I'm gonna name this segment?
What's that?
I missed it with my PSE.
Oh, no. You know, my friends back home in Pennsylvania call me the buck magnet. I just can't get them my arrows to stick to them, though.
Yeah, that's not a good thing.
No.
Brought to you by PSE.
That's what my wife had to say. November 14th, 10 o'clock in the morning, we just saw two different bucks. It's getting into the full moon. Got a southwest wind blowing about 15 miles per hour. They're on their feet now. I think it's gonna be an all day set, it looks like, because two bucks at 10 o'clock running around, looking around. They're looking.
Where are we going, Scott?
Going to Walmart. Got two things on the agenda. Get a doe license for Decatur County. Buck urine, doe urine to make a doe drag. And maybe some soda. I'm gonna kill a deer tonight.
That's for sure.
There you go.
I don't look like they have much.
Other side.
The only thing they have.
Tank 69.
Gee, 688. Well, that stuff ain't cheap, is it?
Hot shot, trophy buck missed. In case they get downwind, we're going to spray it. And then we got tanks 69, Doe and Rut. I'm going to make a drag line. And from where we've been seeing a lot of the activity, we're just going to lay down a line that comes right to the stand. It's going to be a plan.
Get out of our way. We got buck to kill.
Piece of property I just bought. It's only 20 acres. That one buck or two bucks I rattled down. They were right in front of my trailer. This is, I just realized now that I need to move my tree stand. This is an awesome spot. I knew there were bucks in here.
Three bucks
in 10 minutes.
And they're still in here.
But I don't think the rut's heading Iowa yet. Not full tilt.
They're looking for does. They're still together.
Definitely looking for does. Wow. That was good stuff right there, man. Good stuff. Grody hit the doe bleeding. I thought he was coming. I thought for sure he was coming. He wanted to. The wind's just a little bit southeast, and if that was a north wind, we would have had him, no doubt. A couple years ago, my wife and I wanted to relocate. We wanted to move to Iowa because of the good deer hunting. Here, about 8 months ago, we decided, heck with it. Sold everything we had, packed up everything, and moved to Iowa. Quit our jobs. We came here to chase giant whitetails, and today, Rudy and I are seeing the giant whitetails.
It.
You smell like a doe in heat now. We can't take you back in the house. What do you call that, Jen?
The limb grip.
How'd you come up with that?
Oh, that was my husband's idea. I don't know how he dreams up this stuff.
The guys have been using it. It works good.
Good, I'm glad.
What kind of bow are you shooting, Jen?
This is a Parker.
So, tell me about this spot. What kind of land and terrain are we hunting?
Back behind us, there are two big ridges. We're kind of just sitting in the bottom here. Back behind us, there's another big ridge and another bottom. And in the section that we're in, we have about 2.5 miles of just timber, just around.
Didn't see anything, and he kept going.
Yeah, he turned around a couple times. I thought he was gonna keep hit a branch or something because my fin was directly on him. There was a little bit of brush between me and him, but when I let the arrow fly, it looked like it went behind him instead of directly at him.
I don't know. I can't tell.
Well, that didn't work out all that well.
It happens.
I know. At least I tried. My husband will be very proud I come back with one less arrow.
Yeah. Well, we gotta find that arrow.
Yeah, we gotta find it.
I think you're straying at the arm. Because I see your arrow, and it's a mile away to the left. Miss number 3 on the deer tour. I'm gonna call it how to miss big bucks in Iowa.
Here you go. shot, but he turned at the very last second.
I know, I heard you on camera.
Sorry. Right. I kind of swear sometimes.
No.
But I thought he was going to maybe come back, but... And then when I saw, I couldn't see him at first, but I heard the buck, or the eight and the spike sparring a little bit.
Yeah, I got that, I think.
That was pretty cool.
Action.
Yeah, so what's with the lighted arrow? How come it's lit up?
So we had a buck come in, and
how big?
He was a 8, and he came in and kind of piddled around along the came from the west and piddled around along the trail there, and came down and back up, and he finally started to cross, and he was just kind of taking a sweet old time. And so I drew back, and I was at full draw, and I waited, and I waited, and I waited, and he finally moved through an area where I had a clear shot. So I let loose, and my pin was still on the deer, but out of the corner of my eye, I saw the arrow kind of go that way. And my string hit my jacket, and so I completely missed, like by a lot.
Spooked him?
No, he kind of ran off a little bit, and so I knocked another arrow and kind of waited and waited, but he never came into a clear area where I could get a shot off again.
I looked at the footage. That's like 3 feet left.
I know.
Behind the deer's ass.
I know. I saw the arrow again. My pin was right on him. And I
tag for Christmas.
I need a new bow.
I'll get you a bow down for Christmas.
Gotcha.
Well, at least it was a clean miss.
It was a very clean, like way clean miss.
Yeah, and it was a young buck, which was for the freezer. We just educated him a little bit.
Yeah, so now we got our one miss for the day out of the way. So the next one has to be a hit.
You know, I'm going to call this deer tour the miss tour.
We're all doing a very good job of that.
Gosh. Are those mittens you're wearing?
Yes, those are mittens.
You ever practice with those mittens?
No, I don't practice with them.
Take them off. You got to shoot with your bare hands.
But my hands are gonna freeze.
Keep them in your pocket.
Okay, I'll take them.
Oh my gosh. Last year, you know, you just pulled a Willie. Last year in Illinois, Willie shot a 150, 160, and he hit him in the brisket. And it's because his mitten hit his string.
Maybe that's it.
Take that thing off.
Oh.
You pulled a Willie.
I pulled a Willie.
That one too.
This one too.
Yeah, you gotta have the right anchor that you practice with.
Okay, hold on.
I'm gonna burn every minute I see from now on. That's what it hit. It didn't hit your jacket, it hit the damn mitten.
Eventful morning. We had an eight come up on the ridge, couldn't get him to come back in. Then we had a spike come in on the bottom, and he really wasn't interested. He cantered away. Then we had a bobcat come in. First, we thought it was like a little mountain lion, and he spotted us and took back off. And we had a little button buck come in, 15 yards. He came in from the east, 15 yards. I drew back. Let go and watch the arrow go to the left again.
Oh.
It's my mittens. The arrow is hitting my mitten. The vein is on the way out. That's the only thing we can think, is that the vein's hitting it on the way out.
Oh. Okay, so.
When I hold up. Because I checked my stance, I checked my anchor, everything, to make sure that nothing was going to hit it. And all we can think is it has to be my arrows. I don't know.
There's target.
I know. We're going to practice.
Let's try it.
That was big. But that was clear to the right.
We're going to have to get Midwest gunsmithing here to fix your bow.
Something's
not
right.
Normally guns are better, but...
Because I don't ever miss like that. Something's not right.
Something is not right.
Taking a ride, heading to Shields, see if we can have them take a look at my bow, get it set up, and do some troubleshooting so we can figure out what's going on.
Yeah, that's the best thing to do right now.
Yes.
Midwest gunsmithing couldn't fix it.
If it's a gun, we got her taken care of by far.
It's Christmas already.
That irritates me.
Time for a bow tech.
Time for a bow tech. Orion! Mommy needs a new Christmas party.
Your center shot's way off.
Really?
That happened to me.
Well, it's a good thing we brought it in then, huh?
Yeah. What's the verdict?
It's pretty close. A little left, but
it's just
wearing out. But hey, when you get group sizes like that, that is way much better than what we had.
Oh yeah.
Like 100 times better.
Oh yeah.
But I can't shoot anymore. I'm so tired. My left arm is starting to shake.
I know. We may need a pinch hitter this afternoon. All right, we'll get on him.
We'll get on him. We got the bow fixed now, so we should be good.
It's our last hunt.
It is the very last hunt.
We're pulling out all the stops.
Yes. We have a decoy, a doe decoy down at the bottom. Got out the doe pee. We took my bow to the shop to get looked at, and it was all messed up. The center shot was off. The sights needed readjusted. Beep needed readjusted. So now I'm shooting a nice tight group with my bow, which is awesome. So we know that if I miss this time, it's my fault, not the bow's fault.
Yeah. Let's hope you get a chance to redeem yourself.
Yeah, let's hope so.
Redemption.
Redemption. Tonight's the night.
Tonight's the night.
For real this time.
For real. That's right.
All right, Rudy, we're going to come in here. This is, I have a food plot right here. This is oats, some clover, and I also planted some radishes in here. But regardless, we're going to get into this food plot stand tomorrow. Basically, this 100 acres here to the south is all corn, standing corn, and it's the only corn standing in that section and probably for 2 miles. So the deer are constantly in and out of the timber, back and forth in the corn. So I'm expecting we're gonna see quite a bit of deer activity.
At least a doe or two.
At least, at very least.
I like it. So we're testing the Helix broadhead.
We're good.
It's dead deer.
We're good. Rudy, we're good.
Like the way they're flying?
Oh yeah.
Best barbecue sauce in the world, made right here in Iowa. And this right here is our lunch. We're staying in all day, right Don?
All day, bro.
New York style pizza.
All right, Rudy, we're heading to Page County, which is considered Southwest Iowa. In northern Page County, but Page borders northern Missouri.
We're gonna have good weather today, this morning?
It's a little chilly. It's supposed to be windy today. It's supposed to warm up this afternoon, which has me a little concerned. It's gonna be about 60 degrees today.
like it to be a little bit colder.
Hopefully they feed all night, are in that corn, and will come right to us. That's the plan. All right, Ryan, so I'm back. You're the founder and inventor of the Limb Grip, Jen's husband, and I just drove 2.5 hours back to see you guys because of an experience you had yesterday. What'd you see?
I had two monsters come in, bigger than monsters come in, but one of them was non-typical. Points coming out everywhere, like sat dumbfounded by what I see in here. And I didn't even take the time to start counting what was on his head. He busted our decoy, didn't like the decoy.
He hit the decoy?
He came up to it.
Oh.
Didn't like it. And turned. I couldn't get a shot on him. And he ended up leaving, going away. I'm scratching my head, sitting in the tree for about another 20 minutes, and I'm about half deaf. I can't hear real well. But I could hear something walking around, and I was looking, and the way I heard the sound was two different directions. Finally, I looked behind me and seen another one behind me walking away, and he was wide enough to where I could stick my 3-year-old between his main beams. He was just absolutely enormous, and just it looked like deer hands coming out of his head. They were so thin. It was just another one of those. Two jaw droppers in one day.
So we're going to get on them today, hopefully.
I hope so.
It's drizzling outside.
Hopefully I'll keep them in. This timber is usually, it doesn't matter how much wind there is. Yeah. It's calm. I'm hoping they'll be down in that calm bottom.
All right, let's do it.
Yep.
Oh, good morning.
Morning. Ready for round two?
Oh my gosh, I just drove 2.5 hours, I said. This is unreal.
It'll be worth it.
Okay,
right?
I think so. Plus, you had Chinese.
I had leftover Chinese, so we're good to go.
Thank you. Are you tweeting again?
I'm just looking to see what's going on.
Which part of Iowa are we in again right now?
Southwest Page County. We're one county away from being in the very southwest corner of the state.
I think you're going to get the king today.
Boy, it'd be nice if he showed up.
The king is back.
It'd be nice if he showed up. We're due.
We had to get Chinese.
Mm-hmm. Good stuff. An interesting sports opportunity is in your near future.
No way.
Yeah, that's what it says.
And you're all blurry. Can you focus? There should be tenderloins right now. But it'll have to do, and it's good luck.
All right, when it's raining, time to go to Bass Pro.
That's gonna help us get one done.
You think that'll do it?
Yes, we need to get that.
I just need help. Okay.
King Kong Bundy's back. So I'm interested in trail cams and They have a lot to choose from. Don, how do you know which trail cam to pick? What are the top things to look for?
Well, at this point, new technology would be that blackout, which keeps the deer from seeing the flash or the LED lights. I do believe, and I know that the deer see those lights because I often get pictures of deer looking directly at my camera. It's obviously the light that's got their attention.
Do you have a favorite trail cam?
No, I don't. And at the moment, I have not. I haven't bought any recently, new ones. But if I did, I'd probably make a good investment. It depends on where I was going to put it. I'd buy a Reconyx if I knew where it was going. And I
the cheap ones, huh?
No, if I knew that it wasn't going to get stolen. But if it was somewhere out on public land or somewhere that someone else had access to hunt, I'd probably go Moultrie.
What's that?
Gutting gloves.
Use gutting gloves?
Absolutely.
Why?
Because I don't like to get the blood under my nails.
Then you're missing the whole experience.
No.
It's like
I've
cheating.
Done it once or twice. It's a big mess.
It's like cheating. Nice. Use gloves when you cut your food at home?
No. Keeps me clean though. I like that.
Come on. What's that, Don?
It's a skull marker. It's for a European mount.
You think they could have came up with a different name?
No, probably not. You got any ideas?
No, I think of something else when I see that.
You had to go there.
You're pulling a wheelie.
Sounds just like the mule deer.
No, it does not.
Yes, it does.
It does not. Made in China.
They got whitetails in China.
Hosonix.
I'm having real trouble with that one. I don't see how it works in the outside. In a tree stand. In open air. Maybe in a ground blind. I just don't see how it works in a tree stand. There's the Nose Jammer Pro Pack. Deodorant?
That nose jammer works, Don.
Yeah, it smells great.
It jams the nose, especially in the bathroom. After you go to the bathroom?
I would believe that. It smells like
first-hand experience. You see huntography in there, Don?
No, I don't really.
You know why?
No.
I tried getting them in here. They want more kills. We don't have enough kills. You know anything about that?
I guess I'm not helping.
Deer Tour Iowa. No kills.
The Truth 23.
How high do you think they're going to go?
53? 63? I don't know.
The Truth 97.
Prime
hold
bucks.
On, hold on. What are you getting, Don?
Prime time buck 17.
We'll put that on tonight.
Sounds good.
We can actually see your deer getting killed. Unlike huntography. Huntography, where we show you the deer, but don't shoot them. Come on, this is Iowa, Don. What's going on?
Hey, we got tomorrow again.
It's the last day cliche?
That's right.
The ultimate last
Absolutely.
Day cliche?
Absolutely.
All right, lead the way.
Right. That's some pretty poor taxidermy right there.
You wouldn't see that at Cabela's.
Why that seems?
It's like he's got a cross on his chest. He's almost as big as King Kong Bundy. Let's go not kill a deer. Don, this is for you. Put this on. The village people have entered the house. Don, where are we going right now?
We need some spirits.
Some bourbon.
Help us forget this horrible experience.
Oh gosh. Don, I had the perfect bourbon.
Alright. Whitetail whiskey.
We need to get this because right now I have cabin fever. And you're about to let a fireball out. After that Chinese food.
Yeah.
You ever had that whitetail whiskey?
Never, but I'd like to try it.
I hear it helps you shoot deer.
Then let's get it. Let's get two bottles.
Two. Let's do it. We'll need it.
Don, it's snowing. It's not raining.
It's all right.
It's only 3:40. Can we get some backyard bucks?
No, Kim.
Can we go in your backyard?
There's deer back there.
We can shoot that monster.
Maybe he's back there. Who knows?
Iowa backyard bucks. I can climb on your roof and film the whole thing. I can even wear my harness and tie it to your chimney. Here we go. Missing Iowa's deer one at a time. That's how we do. Right, buddy? It's the last day. Last day cliche. Putting on all my gear. Everything I got. It's gonna be 8 degrees. With wind. This is it. This is it. Salt in the roads. Is that salt or sand?
Looks like sand.
So, I didn't film what just happened, but why don't you just explain it? I was too frozen to even move.
16 degrees. Usually not this cold until late season. I mean, I don't remember it being this cold in November in all the years that I've been out here. It's bitter cold. Bitter cold.
I'm talking about what happened in the woods.
Oh. Rattled in a nice 10 point. He came in behind us, of course, downwind, and unfortunately we didn't get a shot at him before he spooked.
Official, Don. It's the last day. The last afternoon.
That it is.
We got fully nose jammed. With nose jammer.
I smell like an ice cream cone.
Nice. French vanilla. Those bucks, they're hiding.
Yeah.
BBD, 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 BBD. Come on, fall, fall. Yes, yes, yes. BBD, 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 BBD.
I just shot a freaking toad, man. My biggest ever. I just shot a freaking toad, man. He's absolutely my biggest buck ever. He's got some kind of drop or kicker or something, but he's a freaking toad, man. I tried to get as much as I could on video. I'm totally stoked. I had him right here at about 25 yards, and stuck him right behind the shoulder. So he dropped right here, probably maybe 20 yards he went. I am totally stoked. The decoys worked. The freaking, the buck was behind me here, or actually in front of me, rubbing. I heard him tearing things up. As soon as he stepped out, I knew I had to have him. I don't know how big he is. It doesn't matter. He's my biggest. I'm pumped. So let's get our stuff together. I'm gonna head out there and let's take a look at him.